patients, I'm sure, coming to you are very, very nervous about terbinafine, about the side effects. They're all convinced that it's going to kill their liver. We actually wrote a paper about this fear factor with terbinafine and looked at what was on the web. And there was really very unreliable information there. So let's look at back at the original clinical trials and what the side effects were. So when we look at the terbinafine group versus placebo, the prevalence of transaminitis in the terbinafine group was 3.3% and in the placebo was 1.4%. And if we look at the prevalence of smell and taste disturbances in the terbinafine group, it was 2.8% and 0.7% in the placebo group. So relative to placebo, smell and taste disturbances were actually more common than transaminitis. And this is something that patients don't even know about. So it's important to counsel them on potential side effects, especially smell and taste disturbances. I have seen a few cases of them. I will say that I didn't warn one of my patients about this when I first started out, and she was pretty mad at me. She was pretty upset. Luckily, her taste did come back. But in light of the fact that COVID-19 can also cause these smell and taste disturbances, I think it's important to counsel patients about it. And we also looked at the FDA Adverse Event Reporting Database. And this is a database where patients can report their side effects, pharmaceutical companies can report their side effects, and then any clinician can report side effects. And there were similar results compared to the clinical trials. So the most common side effect was actually smell and taste disturbances. And in the database, it was about double of transaminitis. So again, important to counsel patients about this.